Good afternoon and welcome to Audio Tree Live. Today is Monday, May 7th, 2012. We're very blessed to have in the studio with us Balance and Composure. We'll be right back.
feet. Flowers that once made you smile turn to stone, grinding down your teeth. Walls around your mind can't keep you safe. Build them up with steel and stone. Watch your soul escape.
And composure on Audio Tree Live. Awesome. Thank you guys so much. Hey, I'd love to hear from each of you in regards to your earliest musical memory as a youngster. We'll start with you, Bailey. We'll start over here. We'll go around.
All right.
Earliest musical memory.
It's embarrassing, but but it was Cher.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you like at it or a Cher record or like a Cher concert?
I just remember being in the back of my mom's 240 Volvo wagon in like the very back car seat.
Yeah.
And hearing that one hit, and then I got the CD, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You would.
Yeah. Dude, Cher. So your mom was like a huge Cher fan or no?
No, it was just on the radio.
If I could turn back time, was that the track?
No, it was the Do You Believe in Life After Love?
Yeah, dude. There we go. He's all like blushing.
Do you believe in life after love?
I don't know.
Dude, I'm down with the share. Yeah. Don't be embarrassed about that gear. That shit is dope.
I'm proud.
Dope. All right, Eric, what about you, man? Earliest musical memory.
Probably like The Police or Sting or something.
Yeah,
my
man.
Parents. I remember driving to the beach with my parents like every weekend, and we would listen to the B-52s cassette tape. And that was, I always wanted to listen to that.
The Cosmic Thing one?
Yeah, the one with the Love Shack on it, obviously.
Yeah, all the hits and shit.
The hits.
Roll, or Roll If You Want To, or what was it?
Yeah.
And that wasn't Roll.
Great
it wasn't,
song.
Dude. Good Stroll, song. Or was it? Something like that. All right, Johnny.
My first concert was Backstreet Boys in second grade.
Yeah.
And my neighbors had an extra ticket, so they took me.
Did you see the support? Did you see?
Aaron Carter.
Yeah, dude, Aaron Carter.
He stole the show.
Yeah, dude.
That was my first concert. But I was first in a DC Talk and stuff, like a whole bunch of the Christian rock rap.
DC Talk was good, man. Those guys were good, man.
They were all,
Jars of Clay.
They held it down. Yeah, that's what I grew up with, but not there anymore.
No, it's all good, man. No problem. Dude, love it. All right, come on now. What about you, Andy?
I remember being like 4 or 5 and being really bummed I couldn't go to an Amy Grant concert with my sisters.
Oh
my
right? Goodness. Yeah.
It was also embarrassing. But
no, dude, Amy Grant, dude, come on, she's sweet, dude. Come on,
she killed it, I guess.
Yeah, dude. Well, and at 4 too, that had to have been the world. Like, and no Amy Grant, dude.
I just wanted
baby,
to go.
Baby, dude.
Just wanted to go.
That's the shit, dude. Can't bag on Amy Grant. All right, last but not least, Matt. Earliest musical memory for you?
Earliest musical memory, probably my dad was a big trumpet player.
Yeah,
still is, and. I don't know, growing up, always hearing him practice trumpet and teaching me to play when I was really young.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, did you play trumpet at a young age? Or?
Yeah, I did a little bit, but pursued
Then you went into
things.
Guitar and bass and
More
stuff?
More drums, and then
nice.
Worked my way over this.
Do you ever jam with Dad? Have you ever jammed?
Yeah, Dad and I jam sometimes.
That's rad, dude.
He kills it.
Yeah, dude.
He's played on some balance tracks.
Dude, so. Well, make sure you guys are always hooking that up.
Definitely.
It's beautiful to have you guys in here today, man. Thanks for being here, Balance and Composure.
Thanks for having us,
Audio Tree.
Dope. Let's just jump into the next one, man.
All right. You doing fade?
This time, pacing back and forth, I find it. gonna fade. Watch it all drift away as I make my biggest gain. Spill my guts to the wall I find. Wasted all my precious time.
Amazing. Outstanding, you guys. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hey, I was hoping you guys could shed a little light for us and our audience about the scene in Doylestown and sort of how that, you know, how that affects your music, the role that that plays in your music.
Well, we've all grew up in the scene in Doylestown, like punk bands and stuff growing up. And I don't know,
is there places to play in Doylestown?
Yeah, there was. There's not anymore.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Doylestown used to be great.
Yeah, there used to be the teen center, the YMCA, which was always popping. We had shows like every weekend.
Yeah, man.
Same bands.
A lot, yeah.
Every weekend, the same show.
Right.
It was a strong scene. Like,
yeah,
it definitely
was.
Made us who we are.
Yeah.
Growing up in it.
And so now there's no gig in Doylestown, so where do you guys have to go to play?
Philly or towns like around Doylestown.
Yeah.
Okay.
But yeah, we all grew up in like the punk and hardcore scene. So
those other bands, the bands help each other out there, or is it sort of a competition vibe, or is it, you know, helpful?
It was definitely helpful.
Yeah.
A while ago. Yeah.
Yeah, it was a cooperative thing.
It really was. There was a sense of community in Doylestown just because, I don't know, it's not a big city. It's just a town that has a bunch of bands in it.
Yeah, man.
So,
well, it had to have been tough when the one venue or whatever. Maybe I'm exaggerating, but if the one venue went away, then everybody's probably like, well, shit. Now we got to really hustle for gigs, and then the competition probably got a little tougher, wouldn't it?
Yes, yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Shit.
Yeah, it sucks.
We're bringing it back. We're bringing it back though.
We're trying to open up a venue there.
Yeah,
talk
man.
About it, but we don't know.
How many people live in Doylestown, man? What's the population there? It's like 100,000 or something
like
that?
No, like 20,000.
Oh, okay.
No way. There's more than that.
Really?
There's way more than that.
Nice try, though.
It's the capital of Bucks County, which is right next to Philadelphia.
It's a small town, though.
Dig it. Well, thanks for being here, you guys. Thanks. I'm glad you're out. You know, you guys just finished a very long tour, right? You guys had like 40-plus dates with La Dispute and St. Hood Reps.
Who?
Dope. That must have been dope. Tell us a little bit about that, man. What was a magical moment from that run, man?
Everything, really. The shows were just way awesome.
Way awesome.
And I don't know. It It was our favorite tour so far. It was just like the bands, the vibe, everything. It was so relaxed and I don't know.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it was
the
really
kids
fun.
Came out and supported, don't they? The kids come
yeah,
out.
Yeah, and every band stole the show.
It was awesome.
It was cool.
Dope. Right on, you guys. Thanks for being here, man. Let's fucking rock the next one.
What's the next one?
All right, let's do it. Stone Hands.
True Claims.
Composure, Audio Tree Live. Wicked, you guys.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, I'd really love to hear from each of you guys and learn from each of you what's a profound concert experience for you guys, a band that you saw that really stirred you or moved you. It could be could be yesterday or could be 10, 20 years ago, whatever's. Profound concert experience.
The best live show I've ever seen by any band would definitely be Explosions in the Sky.
Yeah, man.
Saw them in Philly at the Starlight Ballroom. Yeah. It's pretty awesome. Changed my life for sure.
Dude.
Best band live ever.
Explosions ever. In the room and shit.
Yeah, it was
nice.
Unreal.
Nice. That's what we're talking about. Thanks, Matt. Who else? Who else has got a profound concert?
I saw Bon Iver over the summer, and that was easily the best show I've ever been to.
Where'd you see that at, man?
The Tower Theater in Philly. Yeah. So we were all, I got to sit down and just
Yeah, that's a great spot,
it.
Isn't it?
Was it was awesome.
Super ornate. And
it was probably the best show I've ever been to,
Dope. Was he by himself, or he had a whole
group?
No,
he had 9 people with him in a band, so
awesome.
It was pretty epic.
Awesome. John, what about you, man?
The one tour that comes to mind is there's a tour with Brand New, Manchester Orchestra, and Kevin Devine, and that like kind of blew my mind, that whole tour, because I was a pop punk kid growing up, and it helped me grow. I was like, damn, you can make more impactful music.
Right,
I don't know, and that concert really showed me that.
Nice.
Which is cool.
And
also I got the same kind of vibe from Color Revolt when I saw them.
Oh yeah.
Star Bar. It's like this little bar in Philly. It's awesome.
Yeah, Andy. Tell us more about that show, man.
It just blew my mind. I don't know. They were so tight. It's an awesome band.
Dope.
It's great.
Nice, man. Bailey, what about you, man?
Yeah, 6th or 7th grade, my dad took me to see Saves the Day and Circus Survive in Philly at the Trocadero.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I remember, Circus Survive came out and they opened with they covered Bjork's like Unravel song.
Really?
Something. Yeah.
Wow.
And it was crazy.
I don't know.
That was far out. Yeah, I just remember being completely floored. So
dope.
Yeah, the whole show was crazy. So
dope, man.
Yeah.
You guys are sharing some sweet shows, man. I'm envious. I wish I was at them gigs.
Andy saw the Beach Boys too recently.
Oh!
Oh, I did.
Yeah?
At a music fest in Bethlehem.
Was it proper?
I was watching them from like a big TV, 200 yards back.
How were the harmonies though? Were they nailing it?
Killer.
Dope. That's all we're worried about.
I wish I saw John Stamos on drums, but he wasn't there.
Standing.
Viva drums. John Stamos.
Uncle Jesse.
We're in the studio with Balance and Composure. Thank you guys so much for being here, man.
Thanks for having us.
Rain came down since the day we got home. For days and days it poured into the streams. Kill the peace of all our lost hope. Breaking down my walls and shaking all my sigh of relief. It's nice to have hope, even when you can't believe. The world that I know never had a care for me. Time goes. God who gives a shit anyways. Hear it echo real slow, bouncing off of me to a land that I know. Waited some time for a sigh of relief.
And composer on Audio Tree Live. All right, fellas, we're entering the psychoanalytical portion of the session.
Great.
And I'd love to learn from each of you that if you had to be a life form other than human, what life form would you be and where would you choose to exist? Animal, vegetable, mineral, water, rocks, yeah. Mountains, aliens, moons, all of them are applicable.
Oh my God, it's deep.
I would be a cat.
Yeah, Bailey be a cat, like a house cat.
Yeah, all throughout high school, I would like wake up in the morning, lie down on the couch and look at my cat and be like, I wish I was a cat. I wish I could just do what he does every day. So,
just lamp.
Yeah.
Sunbathe.
Yep.
Dude, sounds like a good life, man. Nobody's really arguing. Everybody's like, well, the cat, but nobody's like saying it would be bad. Dude, that shit would be dope. Matt, what about you, man? Life form other than human.
I don't know. Probably, I guess a dog.
I guess
that's cliche, but
no.
Who doesn't love a dog?
Yeah, you know? Dude. Dogs are loyal. They're as long as you have a good owner, you know, well taken care of.
Yeah,
dog.
Definitely.
Yeah, man.
Dog's got the life.
What kind of dog do you reckon you'd want to be?
Yellow Lab.
Yellow Lab. There
yeah,
we go.
Definitely.
Check it out, man. Andy, what about you, man? Life form other than human.
I'd be an eagle.
Yes.
That soars.
Great.
Yes, man.
I love that.
Yeah, man.
Through the mountains.
Yeah, baby.
How victorious.
Symbolizing America and balance and composure as the eagle.
Yes.
I'm feeling that. I like it.
I'd be a monkey because <He's crazy. laughs> it probably can't get much better than swinging from trees and eating bananas and stuff. So.
No doubt, dude.
That's their life. It's pretty cool.
Right? Just lamping in the jungle?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Maybe even part of like the evolution process and shit.
Maybe.
If we want to get
could
deep.
Be a major role. Start making some
worlds. Eric, what about you, man? Life form other than human.
I'd probably be a cheetah just to know I'm the fastest thing ever to walk on earth.
Hell yeah. You could catch anything.
Just to know that I'm better and faster than everybody.
That's they don't nice have to be animals, though.
Bigger, faster, stronger.
Just faster.
We're all animals.
The spot and shit?
We like animals.
We all want to be animals.
Dude. Hell yeah, dude. You have the balance of composer zoo and shit. It's dope. Wonderful to hear your animals, you guys. Thank you for sharing with us. Thank you for being here today. You guys have one more for us?
One more?
I think we do.
Sure, yeah, we'll do one more.
Let's give a shout out to the Sainthood Reps who showed up.
Sainthood Reps in the building. Holla at your boy.
They're in the house.
They killed it on this tour, by the way.
Yeah.
Sainthood Reps in the house.
We love you, boys.
Shibuya. We're just tuning up here. This is Audio Tree Live, and we're in the studio with Balance and Composure. Doylestown in the house. Thank you.
skipping stones, cross the lake ablaze. Your own damn sake, open wide. Taste we've all been tasting in our tongues and in our minds. And take that head of yours and stick it through the clouds. You've been buried underneath our world with all your selfish doubt. The heat dripping from our dirty tongues, gathering flames now. Just last year we felt the hell of a sneaky spark that had burned us to the ground. There's a hole in all there is to see in these waking days, and it's all fake, open wide. Taste we've all been tasting in our tongues and in our minds.
Guys, hey, before we get out of here, I'd love to hear from each of you, like, what's your current music that you're listening to, current music that you're loving?
Rick Ross.
Yeah, dude. Maybach music.
A lot of hip-hop.
Yeah.
Meek Mill.
Yeah, dude.
J. Cole. No, The National, we listen to all the time.
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah, dude.
Do you guys know the Milk Carton Kids?
Oh, yeah, man. They came in and did a session for us. Those guys, it's like the Louvin Brothers meet Simon and Garfunkel and shit.
My dad sent them to me the other day, and I've been listening to a lot. They're awesome.
Yeah,
they're
man, really those guys are great.
The new Now record.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That's the jam right there.
That is the jam.
Check it.
Yeah.
Everybody's in agreement with that.
So yeah, it's really good. Yeah.
Everybody's like now like a mug.
Yeah.
Collective.
They have a music video out for one of the songs. I think it's Thread.
Is it Gnar?
What was that?
Is the video Gnar?
It's insane. Yeah.
So good.
Perfect.
Dope. Well, shit, thanks for being here, you guys.
Thanks for having us.
You guys have one more that we could maybe throw down, or do we want to call it a day here? Because I'm loving it, man. You know I don't want to sign off and shit. But I also know, you know, a set is a set.
We could. I think we might have one more.
Johnny looks like he's tuning up. Yeah. We're just going to give a big thank you to our video crew here, Megan, Charlie, and Brian.
Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Our engineers today.
They're great at what they do.
John
and
Rick, Patrick.
They feel it.
Shout-outs, Nikki, Michael, Adam. John LeClaire in the house. Let's give him a big shout. Dominic, Ira. Shibuya. Thanks, you guys.
We'll do one more.
Thank you, John. so much for being here. John, Eric, Andy, Matt Bailey.
Thank you.
Balance and composure. Britain, get ready for these mugs. Right after the Olympics, these mugs are coming to your continent. Come and see these guys in August. Balance and composure will be in England. Thank you guys again for being here. This has been Audio Tree Live for Monday, May 7th, 2012. We've been in the studio with Balance and Composure. My name is DJ Evil Vince. Everybody have a safe and beautiful day. Thank you.
Woo!
Dudes!
Woo! You guys fucking killed it, dude.
Fucking amen.